One eternity later.
Hello everyone and welcome to vlog number 2. It has been way longer than I intended, but as it always does, life happens. And I just wanted to kind of update you guys, have a little chat. I really like videos that are talking about real stuff when it comes to art. So basically, buckle down and get ready for a little conversation. So initially, I was showing you guys footage all the way back from the Broadway Street Fair. And that was way back at the beginning of September. I gotta say, I really enjoyed the Broadway Street Fair. I did it with my friend Nikki, who runs Headquirk Designs, a card making company. She makes handmade cards and stuff like that, and she's really awesome. If you want to check her out, I'll have her link down below in the description. But we decided to do a booth together, and it was a lot of fun. I never like really did anything like that, because I just like only had done art in the park the year before, and I was just not really putting myself out there with my art like that. I've only been doing this for 2 years, and the response that I had at the street fair was really great. Like, people came out that I knew, and I met a whole bunch of people, and I just got to really connect with some people over my artwork, and it's just really something that you don't experience very often, and I'm definitely going to try and do it again and do some more stuff in 2020 and do some more markets and stuff like that, because it's just really enjoyable, and sometimes it can be really overwhelming, but I got through it, and I was really happy I kind of put myself out there like that again. Basically, before the street fair, I was revving really hard. I was getting a lot of, you know, artwork done just in preparation for the street fair. I was doing a lot of mini originals and getting prints ready, and it was a lot. And I just kind of burnt out a little after the Broadway street fair. I was just really tired, and I just wasn't able to get a lot of work done. And even when it came to sketching, I was just having a really hard time. I luckily got into some contour drawing and was enjoying that. But even there, I was just constantly struggling with this perfectionism that seemed to like overtake me after this street fair, because I was just having this kind of crisis as an artist when it came to my identity. Like, I just kind of psyched myself out a little, and for like a whole month after the street fair, I just didn't do anything really when it came to art. But I kind of worked through it and worked on myself, and it was a bit of a struggle, and I was dealing with like some panic attacks and anxiety and stuff like that, but I was able to really work through that. And I, at the end of September, we went to the Nuit Blanche, and it was really inspiring. Like, there was all just different types of art there, and one of the artists, who you can see in the final footage that was doing that performance art, like, I ended up following on Instagram. I'll link her information below. It really was very just so raw, and it was super cold out, so props to her for being able to like continue doing the performance without having stopped. I think she did that for like a few hours, and when we got there it was pretty late, so I couldn't imagine. But since then, after Nuit Blanche, I just kind of was working on myself, and then I ended up getting injured and was dealing with that and kind of working on my recovery. And it's a whole lot different if you're choosing not to go and hang out with people and go and do things and stuff versus when you have no choice. So the whole month of December was basically scratched, and I wasn't able to create any art because I just couldn't sit at a desk or really stand at a desk and create anything. I ended up creating this artwork before I got injured, and I filmed the recording of it and everything like that, but it's been an enlightening experience the past few months, just kind of I've just been trying to let things flow and not overthink everything. I feel like sometimes, as I think a lot of artists probably do, we tend to overthink everything, and I struggle with perfectionism, and it can be really frustrating when you're working on something, and I tend to like over-focus on certain areas of an artwork, and then I end up like ruining it because I don't take that time, I don't have the patience. I've been just kind of working with a lot of different mediums, with ink and doing charcoal again, which I ended up doing in this drawing, and charcoal honestly has been really nice. I kind of really hated it when I got back to teaching myself how to draw and stuff. I felt like it was kind of an out of control medium. It was kind of like the same with watercolor, and ironically, I tend to work with those mediums the most now, just because I just like being able to kind of let loose a little and just let the drawing or the painting be whatever it's going to be. I feel like I was like really into digital artwork, but I feel like it kind of ebbs and flows with whatever medium you're working with. So I've been doing a lot of watercolor and charcoal, and this charcoal drawing in particular, I really enjoyed doing. I was just kind of trying to be a lot more confident with my lines and be a little more loose and not so tight about it, because if I'm getting frustrated and letting that perfectionism get to me, I kind of lose something. I feel like I've been just trying to appreciate the value of the looseness and letting things flow as you're working on it, and trust in the process and not be worried about the final artwork. And if the artwork doesn't turn out as great, then just move on. Bad art's gonna happen. I just think that sometimes with social media, we kind of get a little overwhelmed, and we're seeing all these artist posts constantly, this perfect work. You're not seeing the behind the scenes, really, and I think that that kind of can be a little damaging if you're constantly looking at that. So I feel like I've been just trying to detox a bit from Instagram and stuff and not look at it so much. I mean, I still love the platform, and I love looking at other artists' work and talking to other artists, and it's a great community, but I kind of lose sight of what my own artwork is supposed to be, and it kind of becomes a little bit jumbled. So I've been just trying to step back and work on stuff and not really focus on the pressure of sharing it all the time, and just really kind of develop some things and work on studies and just like really enjoy and have that love for art again, because I feel like I got really frustrated for a while and really put under this unnecessary pressure on myself. And I don't know why I do that. I feel like it's that like subconscious comparison between other artists, and I know that's not what I should be doing, but taking a step back from artists that I admire has been really important. I think that studying some of the masters and kind of looking at techniques, and I feel like focusing on contour drawing has really helped me a lot in terms of when I'm creating stuff from my head, or I'm just trying to like draw a study still life or something like that. I feel like things are becoming a lot easier the more practice I put in. I know, such a concept that you practice a lot and you get better at art. Wow. I feel like simple things like that are so very hard to grasp sometimes. It can be really overwhelming in the moment when you're like drawing and you're sketching, and it's like that first sketch of the day, and it's just like, gosh, what am I doing? And then you get discouraged. But I've been working a lot since I've been able to work again, just because for almost a month I just was not able to sketch without like being in pain. So it's been really great. I've been feeling really good about it and just been creating a lot. I got a lot of stuff that I have not shared with everybody, and I have a lot of plans in the new year, and I really just hope I can keep the flow going and not worry about this perfectionism. I feel like that's the number one thing, is like fear and perfectionism go hand in hand, because like I used to get so afraid that, oh, I'm just gonna make this terrible artwork. Oh, it's not turning out well. And A-squar3d is really great being around when I'm like having those frustrating moments. He's like, put it down and move on, do another artwork. And it gets better the more you try to focus on those things. I would say like squinting helps, ironically. It really does. I feel like this drawing I did, the chamomile drawing, I really did it from a photo originally, but I just kind of was squinting a lot and I was just trying to see the form and not to like really focus on if it's going to turn out exactly like the photo, because that's not my aim. I'm kind of just trying to abstract things and kind of pull out the beauty that you can't really see in the photo, if that makes any sense. But it's been quite an interesting journey. I feel like I've kind of really learned that I need to slow down, take that time and enjoy it. And if I need to stop and take a break, then take a break. I feel like sometimes, with just like I said, with the pressure, it's very hard to keep up with the pressures that I feel like this social media machine is creating, especially on Instagram. And everyone talks about the algorithm and this and that. And I feel like I just want to get back to creating and focus on that and share with you guys. And I just want to thank everyone who's been so supportive through everything, especially on Instagram and my friends and stuff like that. It's really important to have that support system, especially when you're going through a tough time and you're not creating. And I feel like everything ebbs and flows, and when you're in it and you're struggling with your art and stuff like that, it can feel like there's no end to it. But it's, if anyone's seen that graph that they have of learning a skill, there's always going to be ups and downs. And once you feel like you've leveled up a bit, you're going to have that down where you feel like, oh, I can't create anything. But as soon as you say I can't, you might as well just throw in the towel, because I feel like subconsciously, and as soon as you say you can't do something, your brain just is like, okay, I give up. If you just go and you try and you're not focusing so much on particular details, you'll figure out that sometimes you're always going to go through that ugly stage, and things will work out. I mean, not every painting is going to work out. I tend to have a problem with overworking things because I get frustrated in certain areas, but find what works for you. I feel like contour drawing's been super helpful on that aspect, and it's really helped with my like charcoal work and painting and stuff like that, in order to just kind of gain some confidence. And you know, you can do it. Just wait until the very end to see whether or not you're gonna like it. And sometimes you need to step back. I usually am the type of artist that sometimes I still do create something in one sitting, and it might be like a small study or something like that. But if it's a really big project, don't feel like you have to do it all in one go. Please don't do it all in one go. At least I tell myself that. Like, I just gotta take a break, you know? But I just wanted to come in, talk about some of the struggles that I feel as an artist, and I feel like a lot of other artists get it. And I mean, if you don't, I guess just maybe learn from my own mishaps that I have, because I feel everyone as an artist, they kind of have this journey. And I started out doing abstract art and tried to teach myself how to draw, and I kind of take things from a different perspective. So I think not comparing and just seeing that my journey is my own, and my other artist friends or any other artist, that's their own journey, is so very important. And I just want to say thanks so much to everyone for your support. There will be a lot more coming in 2020. I hope you have a wonderful holiday, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Check me out on Instagram if you want to, and check out our other videos. Peace out.